everybody used to ask me, you know, do you want to be like your daddy when you grow up? And from a very early age, I got the impression that, you know, this is somebody very important. My name's Steafán Hanvey. I'm from Downpatrick in County Down, Northern Ireland.
Throw me a line, I'll take as a sign that we can.
Bobbie Hanvey, Downpatrick, County Down, Northern Ireland.
Violence like this hit Northern Ireland in 1969.
Living through Northern Ireland and the Troubles was a very nervous time.
After years of simmering bitterness between the Catholic minority and the ruling Protestant regime.
The fact that I was taking photographs of the Troubles and recording the people involved in the Troubles and who were affected by the Troubles, it did keep me sane because it gave me something else to think about other than myself. I used to listen to the radio all the time and had a scanner, and I used to end up in places before the police even got there.
I would hear my dad getting up and running down the stairs, and sometimes if I heard him, I would meet him in the stairs and he'd say, come on with me here. He'd be on the way to the aftermath of a fire or a bomb, you know, an explosion that had gone off. And I remember the heat of a lot of the fires that we arrived at. It was exciting, you know, and then I would get up the next morning and go to school, and while all my peers had been fast asleep, sound asleep, dreaming, I'd been out on this adventure, you know. After a while, he gave me my own camera, and I was happy also taking photographs, and it was very exciting for a young boy to have been exposed to that kind of life.
I am a rambling Irishman, and Ulster I was born in, and many's a happy.
I left school when I was 15. I didn't think it was very important. I thought life was more exciting, and I wanted to go out and enjoy it, so that's what I did. In 1962, my father bought me a tape recorder and a camera, and those two things, in various forms since that, have kept me alive.
Now working on his first book of poetry, you'll be hearing some of his work on this programme in 2 weeks' time. I'm delighted that Sean is my guest tonight. I'm Bobbie Hanvey, the Ramblin' Man, and as always at this time every week, you're very welcome to the Hour programme.
He's an accomplished photographer, radio celebrity, character, eccentric, and
I'm not eccentric.
I was being polite. I was recently looking through the photo archives of Boston College, you know, putting together my multimedia performance lecture that I'm about to take on the road in America, and I thought I'd seen most of the photographs growing up in the household because I'd spent a lot of time with my dad in the dark room. I was just amazed at the photographs I had never seen before, you know. Blown away, really, like bowled over.
Caught myself looking for signs in the strangest places, reading between the lines of the old people's faces. You
say I liked everything about Northern Ireland. I love the people in Northern Ireland because I think they're the greatest people in the world. Even when they were killing each other and being very suspicious of each other, the Protestant neighbour would help the Catholic neighbour and vice versa. And I think that's one of the greatest traits I've come across. I like interesting faces. I've come across women, beautiful women, and they have no makeup on at all. I'd rather photograph a woman like that. I like people to be natural when I photograph them. Also, I think people who are rugged and maybe a bit ugly looking or not conventional, I would like that as well. How did I get time to do all this? Over 1,000 interviews for Downtown Radio. Friends of mine had died and I didn't hear about their funeral to maybe about a month or two later. I just was focused totally on the photography and the recording. This is my 35th year now.
Who's gonna carry you when you go? Family and friends you used to know.
I think that the most difficult thing ever I had to photograph was a funeral. because you have to be so respectful and you have to keep back. It was part of the history, so I had to do it. I did not like it. I did not like it.
I think you're chosen really by whatever it is that drives you. And in my father's case, his mode of expression was the microphone and the camera. And mine is through singing and writing songs. And there's a catharsis involved, of course, in creating all of those things. I think he is an artist.
No, I'm not an artist, no.
It's my turn.
Art is something that is, it's a repackaging thing and a sanitizing thing of a part of history that wasn't very nice, and it makes it more acceptable to people later on. You know, I just think that they're just photographs of a time that happened, and I was there. I was, if you like, it was like being a sniper. You look through the camera the same way as a sniper looks through a gun. You press the shutter, he presses the trigger, and you hope to get something, you know. I don't think there's much else involved to it. I think it's mainly mechanical. There's no way I could call it art. Steafán has come through it all right. He's learned the guitar, he can sing great, he can write great songs. Looks at my photographs in a different way than I do, and I think this program he's got for America is really, really good. It's really good.
When I put together my new album, I started sifting through memories and experiences from childhood, and I realized I was kind of looking back, and it started to become clear to me that, you know, I was actually going home. This is the kind of family I came from. Tradesmen have Fitzpatricks and Sons, and mine was Hanvey and Sons.
You live as long as you have to live, and I reckon I've got 5 to 7 years left, but I really had a great time here in Northern Ireland. I think he's carrying on the torch. If he was in the Olympics, he'd be carrying the torch for me.
Pour me a drink of whatever you think might help me feel half as good as you're looking tonight. Throw me a line, I'll take as a sign that we can't make this thing on our own. Not tonight. Not tonight.